You wake me up for these things, all of
Yes.
you.
Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and start. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the first community podcast where we were supposed to start 15 minutes earlier, but I got stuck in traffic. I cannot help that.
Excuses.
It's dumb because I was the one I was like, oh, hey, everybody, come and get here early, and I'm the one that's late. So, whatever, mistakes happen. But hello, everybody. If you are hype, press 1 in that chat right there. Press 1. Like
one,
that.
Please.
Give me a one. Give me a one. But here
Press
today,
one.
We are going to entertain you with our dumb things, and then.
He entertains a strong word, Jarrett.
Yeah, I know.
We are going to be here talking, and it hopefully amuses people.
You know what, man? I try. I really
try. Two.
That was a striker.
Fuck you.
But after a little bit, we'll be hopping in game, and everybody can come play with us, and it's going to be lit, so. Hope you guys
Whoa,
are ready.
I wasn't aware of this. You're lying to me.
Was
well, I made it
People
up.
People read the chat. We so. Might if we have more time than all the questions that are there.
Yeah, I know.
There's
a lot
of
questions.
I think we.
Yeah, I think we.
Oh well,
got a few.
Let's try this. Let's try this. There's a lot of people here. There's more than two. Dang.
Yep.
Whoa, that's a lot.
That is a lot.
Holy snakes, dude.
I know. It's not updating yet, but it's gonna update eventually. Oh, thank you for the follow. The first follow of the stream goes to Jason Games. Thanks for following, dude.
Yeah, so this is gonna be a podcast.
Hey,
you wanna like
good
put
job
it up on
your
the
follow.
Something interesting is gonna be going on screen.
Yep,
maybe we
so
should maybe we should go down the list, kind of introduce ourselves if anyone's watching this.
Yeah,
so
let's
first
introduce
of all,
ourselves.
We have in the first circle is myself or Miss and Chair.
We can't all see the circle.
So I'm looking at it myself. Whatever. Next we have Dan.
Hey,
Dan.
I'm on a game show. It's based off a show, which is a game show.
Yeah.
Are you game to watch my show?
Hey,
that works.
Fuck you.
That works.
I just made that up just now.
Thank you, Aka Quacka, for following. Then we have Striker.
Hi, my name is the Strikeout Game Show.
I'm sorry, Striker.
Not Striker. Host of the Strikeout Game Show, and did Last Player Standing with Dan a long time ago.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
Time ago.
TBT. Next we have
Xander.
Jack of it. Thanks for following. Thanks for following the Zombie Slayer. Sander!
Thanks for
Sander.
Hi, I'm Sander. I participate in everybody's game show at least once, and I do the like stuff that stuff
gosh.
For Tribal Wars, and I'm cameraman there
Thank
too.
Thank you, IG Afterglow. Next, we have Luigi Spanish.
My name is Luigi Spanish. I'm an Australian that wakes up at 4 a.m. for a podcast.
Thank you, Billy, for following. Next we have Chalky.
Woo! Hi, I'm the gay one.
Yeah! Dude, that's so gay.
Many people at my school would be willing to
you,
tell you otherwise.
Oh.
I guess that's just me. It's a joke on me.
I can see that.
Dude, that's so gay.
I also do Dopaz and Tribal Wars, and I participate a lot. And I win sometimes.
Oh my god.
Nah.
Yeah.
Thank you for following. I'm having too many people follow. I don't know if I should stop thinking.
It'll slow down. It
says 29 viewers. That's like 30 people.
That's like a lot. So a question real quick for everybody. Do you guys want music in the... Oh my god, stop following me! Thank you, Falcon King. I can put copyright music. If anything,
so the point of this podcast,
thank you,
primarily is going to be a Q&A where
45 viewers. Oh my gosh!
Oh wow!
That updated
Discord chat.
That's
guys, I think we should get to the podcasting part rather than it's like, oh my god, we have this many viewers. Oh my god, we have this many viewers.
I know.
Why don't you explain what we're doing here, Dan?
Hey.
Thanks, buddy.
Oh my god.
It's we have a Discord chat, which Discord is an app where we can all kind of connect and talk to one another. It's cool. We all have videos on our channels explaining what Discord is and how to join our community. But we're allowing people from the Discord or people from our YouTube comments or anyone that watches us basically to ask us questions, any one of us, any one of the six of us, and we will answer them. So we have a very long list of questions.
We're close to 400 members on our Discord server. We're at 385 right now. Maybe
That's
we
crazy.
Can push it over to 400 pretty soon. So.
Yep.
Let's
if we
get
can do that during
400
the stream, I'll give away my
members.
Social security number.
I'll give away my life support.
If we reach 400, I'm requesting mine back.
So should we jump into the questions?
Yep, let's go ahead and get started. So this is just an either or for everybody. Would you rather do YouTube but don't have Twitch, or would you rather do Twitch but don't have YouTube? So would you rather
do Twitch?
I think we should go through the cycle. We should go through the circles as we introduce ourselves. So Jarrett,
honestly, I
do you guys have the circle? Okay.
I would say
this question was
like a print screen.
JC, by the way, Gaming JC sent in that question.
Okay. Yeah. I would honestly go with streaming. I love streaming more than doing YouTube videos because it requires less work. Smiley face.
You wouldn't exist without YouTube, mate.
Yeah, I know. I know.
I am going to be different than this stupid head. I say I would rather have YouTube but no Twitch. Because you can stream on YouTube, even though it's worse, still possible to stream.
Technically, you can post videos on Twitch. You can highlight them.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with YouTube. It's more time to make it look pretty, as opposed to the kind of raw uncut thing that we're dealing with right here, right now.
Excuse me.
Yeah, but I like to heavily edit my stuff, and this kind of content I produce would not be well on a live stream because there's a lot of chaos and such. So I think, one real quick to answer Hasselking's question. No, Hasselking, I will not unblock you on Twitter. Stop tweeting me pictures of your scrotum. Anyway, go on, Striker.
Sander, what about you?
I'd go for YouTube, because the simple reason I can mass record one day and then not have to record for a month. I'm a terrible YouTuber.
Same.
God, and I don't even Twitch, so.
See, for me, it's the type of videos I make are very special, and they might not work on Twitch. If you catch my TDMA announcement, there was some very special editing involved.
It was
not possible on Twitch. I have a Twitch, I just don't use it ever.
You have to understand it. I pretty much live on Twitch. I don't know, I just prefer it more.
Now I'm passing the mic to my boy Joey Jambo.
I would much rather have YouTube. I've had experience on Twitch and just it all. I'm not very good with solo commentary myself, so I prefer the whole YouTube environment. So,
a quick note to you guys: I'm gonna delete the question after we do it. So we just have to
thought. Okay.
Right. Hey, Anna. Hey.
All right. Next question was aimed at Jarrett, but I guess we can all answer it. Are you ever going to play in game show?
Okay.
Jarrett had the proclamation at the end of TDM 7.
Yeah. I've been asked this question a lot in different Q&As. I did a Q&A on my channel recently, and I had the same question asked, and I keep on getting asked in streams or whatever. Honestly, I don't know, because after the school year, I realized, man, I don't have as much time as I used to, but I think if there's a big show that comes back, LPS2 or some bullcrap like that, then I would.
Don't put that kind of pressure on
I mean, it really depends. I just had to be feeling it again. And doing
it depends if you want Jarrett
co-hosting
back.
That was really fun. If you want me back, press 1. Press 1 in the chat if you want some Jarrett back.
Press 0 if you're happy Jarrett's gone.
That question was by Undead Wolf. And I want to throw a quick thing about that, kind of related. If you guys watch some of our shows, there's a rotating cast, and so we don't always have the same people every season. So, for example, Dan and Luigi didn't get to play last season of Strikeout. I didn't play in certain seasons of certain things. It's not always that we don't want to play. It's sometimes that the timing just doesn't work. We got something going on. And there's a lot of people to organize, and if one person can't make it, you don't change the entire game show's recording time for one person.
To add to what Striker's saying there as well, there's limited slots for these game shows as well. We can't have Strikeout, which is designed for 8 players with 20 people playing, because that just wouldn't work.
Yeah, thank you for the one.
Yeah, I'll think about it. Amen to that. That was a good point, Striker. I try to add more people. TDM LPS had 18. That was a crazy time. TDM8 had 16. That was a crazy time.
Uh-huh. But, like, strikeout.
Don't blame the game show creator when don't show up. Because it's usually don't show up or, like, have an obligation, or, like, a pre-existing obligation. They couldn't make it. It's not my fault. I didn't pick these people. I just invited them and the first people to show up. Or,
about how, like, these people, like, attend and stuff. I'm just going to use a few examples. So I was set up to be in strikeout 7, and I fell asleep. Like, it wasn't, like, I wasn't able to make it. Like,
I didn't drive fast enough.
Yeah, that's why we missed it. Like, sometimes
and that's why Flores and me showed up.
Sometimes it's, like, not in our control, so, like...
Yeah. And
also, you got to think... the more people we have, the longer the game show is going to take. Like, recently, the few game shows we've recorded have been taking almost 8 hours to record sometimes.
I just recorded a game show this morning that was on our third day of recording.
Yeah.
Put that in perspective.
Sometimes it's a pretty big ordeal.
Yeah, and at the end of the day, like, you got to just take a step back and be like, this may be a job to some of us, but they are games... I don't want to invalidate our work, but sometimes things
Sticks
are
in
more
the chat, by the way.
Stig's in the comments.
Thanks, man.
I at Stig.
Oh,
at
you're going to break that up.
Watch Stig's weakest link. I'm in it.
All right.
That was a spoiler.
Should we go on to the next question?
Yes.
Yeah, I think so. Right. Have we
next
all...
from... You got it, Luigi?
Yeah.
Do it.
Oh, you want me to read the next question?
Yeah, you should.
Oh.
Right, I wanted you to talk.
Oh,
and
my
then
God.
Just...
Wait. Which? Because this question all right. is
so this was
Dan.
By the Toad in a Tuxedo question, and whoever's got the guest thing, I can't read the question. You're covering it. question for your live Q&A. For everyone, what is the most hilariously pointless thing you have ever done?
Breathing.
let's start with Chalky. Start with Chalky.
Way back. Is this like general? Like,
yeah, the most hilariously pointless thing you've ever done.
Oh,
I was in TDM like 8 times. So
yeah. Get a life, dude.
And I still haven't won. So, you know, I mean, or have I?
Ooh, Kappa.
Wow.
Kappa alert.
Gosh,
if I may,
if anybody's got something to speak up.
If I may take the reins. I have a cosplay of my Minecraft skin. No. Let me explain. The cosplay is of a Mormon because I like the musical The Book of Mormon, and my skin just happens to be that plus my face.
What does a Mormon look like?
Dude, it's a short button-down white short-sleeve shirt, which is hard to find because button-downs are usually long sleeves. Black skinny tie, black dress pants, black shoes, large white smile, and a hate for gay people.
Oh,
yeah.
Hell yeah.
Go on, someone else's turn.
Okay,
and yet you're lying.
I have a cosplay of Steve. Not a joke. I have the pickaxe, right? I have pickaxe. I have the square head. I have the blue shirt, blue pants. And I'm full. But that's not the thing I wanted to say. The hilarious, what was it? Hilarious, pointless thing I've ever you do whatever. I had a time where every UHC I did. And Flores participated in it either. I usually had the tendency to die before Flores did. For those who don't know, Flores is my younger brother. What I'd do is younger? I'd climb onto the roof from my window, and I'd hang in front of my brother's window. Now, this is not a safe thing to do. Kids cannot do this at home.
Please.
But first time I did this, I've done this multiple times, I said, "Hey, Flores," and he's sitting right in front of the window. And he turns around, because I usually end up standing, like, the doorway, and it's behind him. He's like, Sander, where are you? And he turns back to his computer and sees me hanging in front of his window, and he just screams and almost falls back on his chair. This has been multiple times, and I've scared him shitless a couple times. and I may or may not have fallen down once. Let's just say I have cat reflexes.
I'm sitting here trying to come up with one. I'm sure Luigi's sitting there like, I have too many to choose from.
I already have one. I have one in mind that really stands out, and that's doing Club Penguin for 7 years.
Yeah! I have an older penguin than him. I have an older penguin than him.
Shut up, Jarrett. I'm gonna play
I think I might have an older penguin than you. I just forgot the password.
I have an older penguin.
No
Story time with Sander. Yes, Ben, I know.
I don't think I have a... I can't think of a pointless thing, but you, Sander, the scaring your brother thing... I got my mom really good the other day. So her phone syncs up to her car starts playing music whenever she gets in, turns on the car, it just comes on.
Oh, my God.
And on her phone has some of my music. You guys know Rise Against?
Yes.
You know the song Give It All?
Yes.
It's like, it's
nope,
from that,
but I'm
about to start
to
playing
now.
It, but I
if
can't.
If you just Google Give It All, like, yeah, it skips like 10 seconds.
It's
and
it's hype.
Like, so she left her phone in the car, and I went to the music and put it up to 10 seconds and cranked the volume and held onto the phone. God. And she got in the car, I hit play, and she nearly jumped out of her seat.
Oh, it was awesome. Del, yeah.
We're always
going to kick you out of the house.
Gotcha.
Alright. Anyone have anything else on the hilariously pointless one?
What about you, Joey Tambor?
I already did.
I said breathing. But
good paying attention.
You said breathing like immediately. Like that was impressive.
Well, actually, hold on. There's one thing I did. I didn't know how to turn on my PS4, so I had to look up a video on how to turn it on. So.
Wow.
I couldn't tell. The button's so small.
You know something's wrong.
I know. It was bad.
Alright. Next question.
Next question. Don't get me to read the questions, please.
You want to read that one?
No, because I don't have the document open.
Oh, okay. Well, from Michael Santelli, are you going to do another season of Last Player Standing?
Yes.
Wait,
I'm gonna let you walk this one. I'm gonna let you walk the plank on this one.
Me?
Yeah. Yep.
Go, Dan.
All right. Can I level with you? Hashtag level in the chat, please, because I need to talk to you. LPS was nuts, dude. It was bonkers. All right. I'm not saying no, but I'm not saying yes. Me and Striker have talked about it.
Let me just say this: if we were ever to do it, it'd be very different.
Oh. Yes,
I'm not getting out to rock paper scissors.
That would not exist.
It'd be different in the fact that it'd be more well run, and it'd still be a balance between my show and his, but it wouldn't be. It'd be different. I don't know how to explain.
It was like a trial and error, and that was just the error part.
A lot of new people.
But we did have fun, and we liked it.
Yep.
I loved it.
I kind of figured that. Chalky.
Well, I remember Striker being really upset when all of the strikeout people who got out were like really early.
Well, I wouldn't say upset, but I was a little frustrated because it seemed like everyone that I felt like should have gotten further didn't. Like they just got screwed over by rock paper scissors. Like the couple that stood out were I think Dark, Leo. And I think Jarrett, I think all three of you guys got out. Because Jarrett, at that point, I called you a strikeout guy at that point.
Yeah.
I got two of them out.
Some of the reasons strikeout went out first because they were seen as very dangerous people. So all the DDM people were like, vote for them!
These
guys actually have to be good to win their game show. Let's get them out.
Let's go. No, whenever I targeted Fudge, that's when it was all over for me.
Oh my god.
It was all
but that leaked out. It was
I wish I still had that clip.
I feel sorry for Luigi.
Guys got
this
some cojones.
Yeah, though.
My opinion of LPS, because at the time I was like actually watching through this. Not gonna lie, Dan, I wasn't subbed to you when I was watching LPS. But when I checked I was like, hey, it's okay. I didn't know who anyone was, and I had no idea who Jarrett was. I was kind of just like, oh, bye.
I guess moving on, if you guys are good to move on.
Yep. Yeah.
Next one's from King. Yeah, you go for it, yeah.
All right. This question comes from King Fuzzy. Is season 9 already being planned out? And I'm guessing that's for Striker and Dan.
Yeah.
Ooh, the voice crack.
I'll go first and let you go after that, Dan. As a general rule, aside from my stupid finger, because it kind of threw a wrench in the system, but by the time season, like, for example, 7 and 8, by the time season 7 finishes uploading, we're about to film 8. And so season 9 is basically done, but I've had a huge bump in the road, so I'm almost done with it, and it'll be done soon. I've got plans for 10, I've got plans for 11. I plan on keep on going, so.
My answer's a lot shorter. Nope.
After
want Jarrett
recording
to come back if we do another one, but I have no idea. TDM is very different than Strikeout in the fact that we just kind of throw everything together in the last day.
You know what's even more different to that? Tribal Wars, which we spend 6 months on and then don't upload.
It's either you're a Striker, a Dan, or a Chalky.
To upload. Can I answer this next question, please?
Yeah.
All right, Amber Timons Amber Pumba asks, how did you meet Luigi Spanish? This is a good one.
I voted for him.
I let you explain.
I voted against him.
I think everyone can take part in this question. You can start, Dan.
I got the idea to do. People were asking me to, like, oh, can fans play? I'm like, no, but maybe. I made
good
one
point.
One person can get in the show. How about that? And I accepted applications, and then we were looking through them all, and we're like, all right, so I narrowed it down to, like, what was it? Like, 6 people?
Possibly.
I thought it was like four.
I, by myself, narrowed it down to, like, 4 people. Like, I composed lists for myself, and then I started choosing until I narrowed it down by myself to 4 people. And then I raised it to, like, the regulars of the TDM. Yeah. These 4 people go vote for them. And Luigi was picked as the winner. Wait, no! Luigi was not picked as the winner.
It was a tie.
Audio Beam won that.
Yeah. That's very true.
I was drinking when you said that. He was not picked as the winner. What?
No, Audio Beam did it, but then, like, he couldn't make it, so I'm like, oh, Luigi Spanish is the winner. So, and Audio Beam ended up being in season 6, but and I like him, he's cool. But
Audio
Luigi
Beam
was
is
there, and then I met him, and I'm like, hey, do you
like...
And then, like, we became best buddies.
The first call we were in, we played Splatoon, and I showed you my Amiibo collection.
You did! We played Splatoon, and you showed me your
I got a different story.
Good times.
Wait,
you go, Striker.
On this note, what the hell actually happened to Audio Beam?
He disappeared.
His computer is, I don't know if it's still broken or not.
Right. I don't know. Didn't know him anyways.
Yeah, so
what's that?
Whenever after Last Player Standing, I took like a 7 or 8 month long break. Oh, I just got off the internet for a long time. And when I came back, Luigi was like a thing. And I came back to do Strikeout 5. And we were
really
Dan, since Dan was gonna record it and edit and all that stuff for season 5, we were just trying to plan out who to go for, and he's like, oh, we should get Luigi. I'm like, who? Who's this guy? We brought him in. He was fun. So it was weird. Fun. Like, you leave for a while, you come back, and then this person is like a staple of the group. I'm like, I don't even know you. What happened?
Let's see. Back in
I've never met Striker, and I'm like, what? You haven't met Striker?
Yeah. We and Striker like talked during one of I think it was Jarrett or Dan's streams. Like, it was really like. Frequent, not frequent, but like on and on when like I'd get to talk to Striker briefly, and that's how I kind of like got to know you a bit in a way. Mm-hmm. And I was like invited to Striker 5, and I was like, oh, cool.
Same.
Anybody else got a meeting Luigi story?
I hate Luigi. We went to a water park together.
He was the fan contestant in TDM5, and then I was like, dude, we need to not look bad. We need to make this guy not be out.
Oh yeah, didn't you like work together trying to help him out that season?
With him.
Yeah, me, God. Jarrett, and Sander.
I remember. Oh my gosh.
Me, Jarrett, Sander, and Luigi.
Drop it.
Can I lay down? So I was like, I'm gonna change the game. People are gonna fear me, and I got out.
Yeah. Okay. Can we like release Luigi's audition, please?
I can find it. Hold on. Give me like 5 minutes.
I saw in chat like people were abusing, so I was like, oh yeah, Jarrett's on
use
the
code. Me
and him work together.
Okay, right. I can kick you out of this, by the way.
That's in my audition. This is my Discord server. Like, that's in my audition when I was like, I'm gonna change the game. People are gonna fear me, and I got out.
Okay. Can we like release Luigi's audition, please?
I can find it. Hold on. Give me like 5 minutes.
Let me do it on the 1 year anniversary. It's coming up in a few days. I think.
Is it really
May 8th? Yeah, May 8th. That's when I made it.
Okay, that's fine.
All right. Next question.
1 year of existing.
From Toasted.
Oh.
Ask the question.
You sure? You ready?
Yeah, go
I'll deliver. I'll deliver it.
Please do. All right.
From Toasted. When will you finally kill yourself, Dan, in your suffering, you miserable scum? I added this scum.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's not written there.
Yeah, Toasted.
You got your own feeling, Striker.
So, yeah, the question is, Dan, when will I finally kill myself? That's a very interesting, and it's actually a very good question.
Very thought-provoking.
I've been thinking about it a lot recently. Should I go for like the serious answer or the funny answer?
Just be like, and I gotta go.
A little bit of both.
Be right back.
To give a more serious answer.
Next question. Okay.
There's.
Oh no, he's mid answer.
There's been a time in my life. There was a time in my life not too long ago where I was, clinically depressed and I was suicidal. I'm still technically clinically depressed, but I'm no longer suicidal, and I do attribute some of that to people who watch me and who comment, and it may be a small gesture to watch my video, and it may seem like you're not doing anything for me, but it really does mean the world. So, when I'm going to kill myself, I cannot give you an exact date. It's not. I haven't penciled it in yet, but I can guarantee it won't be now.
All right. If that person is in the chat, like the first thing they hear is like, shit, 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 shit. I should not.
No, I don't take it personally. I want to die.
I feel like
we're getting onto a serious topic.
Yeah, let's change it up, please.
All right. Next question. This one's for Jarrett. When did you have the idea to do your show?
Basically, I talk to myself a lot, so I thought I would talk to myself on the internet. It was basically, there was this guy, I don't know if he still does videos, I Am the Attack, or whatever. He used to do this, show where he would just talk about random things in his life and stuff. It's called Lane PhD or whatever. Go look it up, it's really funny. So I basically got that idea from it, because I was like, you know what? I like talking about things, so I'm just gonna talk about things too. So.
Alright. Was that, I guess we can kind of go down the line. Dan, you want to talk about TDM?
When I get the idea to do my show? Yeah. When? I don't know. I think Chalky still has the chat logs, but I, like, assembled, like, a group of, like, 3 people, and I'm like, yo, I got an idea for, like, a Minecraft Survivor thing. we should do it. No, it was Link Master 13. Link
you
Master
did
13
it to
was, like,
me as well.
What?
He sent it to me as well.
Oh, okay. Well, no, you were in the chat, but Linkmaster 13 was the one who gave me the idea for it. And then, like, the next fucking day, Striker's like, the Strikeout Game Show. I'm like, fuck! So I'm like, you know what?
Crap.
Without communicating, we both... It was weird.
No time but today.
And then I did it. On that same thing, I uploaded the first episode on October 1st, 2014, so I'd assume sometime in September. It was pretty quick. It was like idea, recording, upload. It was pretty rapid fire on that first season. So, September 2014. There you go.
Oh, yeah.
I've got a different story. So I have two. So back in the year 2009, this was when the Club Penguin toys were like first releasing. And I got them, like, on day one. And I was watching videos of, like, this guy recording them and, like, making stories. And I'm like, hey, that's pretty cool. So I got out my Nokia phone, and then I just started, you know? Nokia. And I did that for about 7 years. And now, today, I got the inspiration just to entertain, just because it's fun.
Yeah, let me pull up my Verizon phone.
I love my at phone.
At T.
At T. At
Yes. Shout out to you, B Funky's chat. You made this career of Club Penguin possible.
Chalky Sander, you want to talk about Tribal Wars?
Chalky needed help with Tribal Wars. I joined in. Chalky, go to the red.
The original Tribal Wars was basically after one TDM, and like Dan was talking to me about like the fact that some people only were like in one episode and disappeared, and I was like. People.
Is he kidnapping us?
Yeah, he's cutting out. This just happens. Like, okay. I've been on Mumble for.
Hello.
He's lagging. I'll just talk for him. He was watching the Strikeout Game Show.
And it inspired him. Hey, guys, amazing show. Check it out if you haven't seen it.
Because people were getting out in the first episode and they weren't getting any more screen time, I thought that it would be fair to like do a different way. Where, like, everyone could be past the first episode, so...
Well, I mean, if you're bad, then you gotta get out early, man. Like...
Yeah, third episode.
If you're bad, you should... Mm-hmm. Don't... Fair enough.
Alright.
Next question?
I plugged that finger thing in there because I've been getting, like, 1,000 questions. Even today, I just got a bunch. I'll quickly run over this real fast. I don't want to waste time on this.
Let's go.
Yeah.
No, I want you to
about 4 weeks ago...
Written,
about 4 weeks ago, I broke my middle finger on the middle knuckle, shattered the knuckle in 4 pieces.
Shivers.
I had to have reconstructive surgery last Friday. No, not last Friday. Two full weeks ago, I had the surgery. And then I got to have the pin. I got to go back in another 3 weeks. And then probably within 4 weeks, I'll have another surgery to get the pins out. And I'll be healing probably for the better part of this year, trying to get my full function back in my finger. So that's the situation, but I'll be okay. I will live.
How did you do it again?
So
watch that video.
I just hit it on the ground the wrong way. I was down on the ground and my finger hit it and it just went off to the side. I thought I just dislocated it from that knuckle. Cause when I looked up, it was like a straight line up to my knuckle and then like a 45 degree angle to the left.
Ew.
And I just shoved it back in place cause I thought I dislocated it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I was seeing stars and my ears were buzzing. Anyway, dang. Moving on.
Strike.
Who's got the next question? Who wants to read it?
Sure.
Expired Cheese asks me. Oh wait, no.
No. Paste it at the bottom.
Stand or go.
Add it to the bottom.
What was the hardest season to film from all the partners' game shows?
TDM season 8!
No, I'm gonna say Strikeout.
See, I only have two.
LPS.
Hey.
No, I would say that's almost the easiest because we had two cameras.
Strikeout. LPS was actually quite easy.
Like editing, I can imagine, was a freaking nightmare.
Oh, yeah, editing.
Filming process.
Yeah, filming.
Especially when I'm like away, I'm like, oh, he's gonna put the episode up today. Oh, wait, he quit.
The hardest season for me to film was Strikeout season 5. It was just so difficult.
Wow.
Wow. Okay. The only season.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a second. I filmed that one.
If you didn't remember, like Dan filmed season 5. I did nothing. So.
I got the reference. Okay. See. Anybody else want to answer that? I've only filmed 2 game shows, or have I? But SOM2, only because I had to narrow it down. Mainly due to like last minute calls, and I'm sure you guys can like relate to that. We need to like make a last minute call, like a
thank you, Ranger Guard.
Let me throw this at you real quick. It just started pouring here in Houston, like there's all this flooding and bad weather. If my power goes out and I leave, that's why. I'll hopefully be back.
One of my friends lives down there, and he took a boat to school, and he sent me a Snapchat of it. It was pretty cool.
There's some massive flooding going on here outside of Houston. It's pretty crazy.
Stay safe, man.
I'll be okay. I'm not anywhere near a point where it'll be
I'll
flooded,
set sails
I might
for
not
you.
Be able. I might get a couple days off work and school, which would be
hey guys,
fantastic.
What's Jarrett gonna say to Striker when he drowns in the flood? Safe sails, bye bye.
I saw it coming.
Oh,
hey, Shrek, look
Rob,
in chat how...
That was still easy to film, bro. Yeah. Editing was tough.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
if the question's right. Filming, yeah, if the hardest one to edit, absolutely season 6. Screw that season.
That was so funny.
I would have just done it again, but I can't...
I'm glad that we should have...
Everyone had already seen all the challenges.
I sure you filmed it.
Yeah, give Busterful another chance. Press 1 if you want to see Busterful.
1-1-1-1-1-1-1.
Press 2 if you want to see Luigi full play again.
Oh my gosh. Wait, if you put my name into anything, it goes wrong. I'm just saying.
Fair.
Yeah, awesome.
Go on, next question.
Okay.
Yeah, next question. All right. You guys ready? Next it's question. From Expired Cheese. Which is a great name. So, question for Jarrett and Dan. What drugs do you and Jarrett take, Dan?
I think this is at the April Fool's video.
This was...
Wait, what? Daddy's Home or whatever it's called.
The survival series.
Oh!
Oh, yeah, and that thing, too. The Daddy's...
Honestly?
No, I think it was at my, it was at my, face when I recorded the video in New York. I was a little loopy. But I don't do drugs, man.
How do I drugs explain myself true. Then?
I've never done a drug. I took steroids for my nose when it was a little stuffy. That's about it.
Whoa. Okay.
I've never even seen a pot. I don't
he's
know
gone.
How I cook
this
anything.
Guy is gone. 420 was a couple days ago, but he's still not here.
Retweet.
Oh, I barfed. Oh, I barfed.
Nice. If I had to say any drugs I take, I don't know, man. I'm so gone, I can't even tell anymore. This morning I took tape. I don't know.
Tape?
Yeah, and I have a kazoo. I don't even know where this came from. Yeah.
Scotch or duck?
I don't even know.
Duck.
Quack.
Quack, quack, quack.
Hell yeah.
Alright, next question.
Who's got it?
Next question.
Luigi, you got this.
I got this.
No, I'll not answer.
By Luigi, I'm in
Dan. I don't want to read.
Flameshot 258 asks.
Oh, just before you say the question, the plus the last part, I added that. Just because.
Yes, okay.
Oh, thank you so
Flameshot 258 asks, me and Striker, who is your favorite contestant of our game shows? I have mine. It's Gamershan 05.
Hell yeah.
I don't know who Striker's is.
Dude, the favorite contestant thing, that's rough. It's hard to have favorites.
No, yeah,
my favorites are
me.
The people who have not won a season.
Oh,
hey. High five.
It's not Chalky.
Yes, Chalky.
Nobody wants to see the same person win.
You know, I always get comments about Mama Slime. She played in one season, the first season. And because
she has two X chromosomes, dude. Get used to that shit.
No, but I've had other girls that are in the season, and it's not the same.
Luigi.
I don't know. I guess if I had to pick a favorite one, it'd have to be my brother Falcon King.
Aww. Why are you kissing? That's incest.
Wait.
That's incest.
Remember, the objective of Strike Out is to torture the contestants, so, all right.
Yeah.
Anyway. Favorite contestant is torture. what's the next thing?
Will
you ever do a game show besides your current one?
I did. Watch the last player standing. Me and Strike did an okay job.
Me and Dan are going to do The Bachelor. Lobo. Wink, wink.
Oh, we are going to do The Bachelor. That was
we actually have to do that.
Me and Mr. Jarrett are like... actually planning to do The Bachelor at some point.
Janet.
Oh, that is going to be fun.
On that note,
it will not be fun.
If the strikeout game show, whatever, or the way it's set up currently ever gets boring or too repetitive, then I'm definitely open to changing it. I've got other ideas
Thank
that
you,
could
Lazy Girl.
Lead other ways. So
the strike-in game show.
The strike-in, yeah. That is the secret.
The strike-in game show.
It's the spin-off show.
Like, you start with one member...
It's
and then three members.
It's Fear, the Strikeout Game
Show.
You
get more friends. It's fun. My new game show is going to be called Total Cooperation Minecraft. It's going to be a nice time where everyone works together.
They already do that, Dan. They already do that.
I know. Okay.
All right.
Next. By the way, everybody, I'm taking the questions and putting them at the end of the list, so the ones okay. that we can answer for the people in the chat. Anyways.
Ivan Zayas asks, are you planning on doing things besides Minecraft in the future?
Danny, go.
Club Penguin.
Club Penguin, yes. actually, this is a good time for me to shamelessly plug myself.
Oh,
hey, everyone. Cool. You may know me as the fun-loving Minecraft game show host, Dan Han Dan.
Fun-loving.
But did you know I also write musicals? That's right.
With Matt Ridley.
If you go right now to youtube.com/wetpainttheater, that's theater with an R-E, folks, and subscribe, you'll be notified when my original musical, To Kill a Mockingjay, which is a parody of The Hunger Games, releases on YouTube. The album will come out on iTunes and Google Play the same day. I am dead inside. Luigi, you're up
you
next.
You maybe lose 70 viewers.
Okay, so...
70 viewers out the drain. I need money. My son needs money. Oh, yeah. I need shoes. Hey, Jarrett, can you go into the restaurants and start collecting bread for me, too?
Yeah. I'll get it done. Anybody I'll go into
hang
gondoliers.
Up flies.
Anyone just else hang on the flies. Non-Minecraft question?
See,
I do.
I didn't catch any of that.
Chalky,
I have been bought various games to record for Let's Plays, but I haven't. That's
the ending of Super Mario 64 coming out?
Yeah, I know. Never. Legit. No, what? Are you serious?
I lost my save. Oh my I'm sorry.
And just start again, episode 5.
I was watching it religiously.
Episode 5?
It's hard to do different games because you don't get as many views. I mean, it's not all about views, but it's really discouraging.
People come to our channels for one thing. If you do something else, it may be like, oh, I'm branching out, but also be like, oh, cool, 6 people watched.
My Super Mario 64 series is the most watched thing on my channel for a long time.
Or you can be like Chalky and just be the weird outcast, like that actually gets what he wants from it.
Yeah, on the views thing, it's not necessarily about the views, but it's about pleasing your audience. If you guys enjoy a certain game, then we tend to do more of it.
Yeah.
And usually the things we do are the things we enjoy anyway.
Yeah. I hate myself.
Yeah. Oh.
I am doing U-Realms on my channel. For those unaware what that is, it is something along the lines of Dungeons & Dragons role-playing. Come check. I make the lives of Chalky, Merlin... Too. Wait, Chalky, Merlin, Ben, and Jack horrible. And I'm making Infernox play Bully next week.
No,
It was supposed to be yesterday, but 2 people didn't show up.
I'm going to steal the question from the Twitch real quick from Network Dog. Jumping ahead on here, sorry. This is a question for everybody. Would you rather have record a 20-person season or do 8-person seasons on Roblox? So if I ever did a 20-person season, I would mute every single person. It would literally just be me talking. I'd probably get a co-host, and they would just be muted. Because there's no way. 16 was a freaking nightmare. 18 on Last Player Standing, 2 people trying to maintain. That was a nightmare.
You could have a script, like, so people only talk at a certain time. Like,
yeah,
5 seconds.
That'll work.
Do a script. Like TDM,
that'll
right?
Work. Yeah, like
10
that.
10 seconds
like...
later, Dan says, oh, I'm dying. No. Please help.
All right, let's move it along here. Next question.
Okay.
How long do seasons of your game show last? Are they all done in one sitting, or are they done the way we see it, where you wait till the next day to record after every elimination? So I'll kind of do a general thing on this, and we can all jump into it. Everyone does their shows differently. There's some people that... they record their shows in multiple sittings. I'm going to give a shout out to a friend of ours, Billy Bo. Billy Bo 10K.
And Steak.
Yeah, he's in TDM8, but he also did, he does a show called Raven. Check it out. Someone throw us a link in the description or the chat.
His channel every day.
Yeah, he does a great game show over there, but he records it in one sitting. Or he records it each day. He records the day of the recording. is one episode, and then they stop and they come back together. And when you do that, it's when you got a smaller cast, it's a little bit more possible. I think there's about six people in each season of Raven.
I don't have Slink.
But if you were to get, if I tried to do Strikeout 8 in one recording or in multiple days, 16 people trying to record those same people for multiple weekends in a row. Are you kidding me?
Oh, it's
that'd be impossible. Yeah, I mean, it's tough enough to get, like, I was talking to Billy, like, it's tough enough to get six people. Like, it's ridiculous. So, yeah. I like to do all mine in one sitting. Sometimes it takes 3 to 4 hours, but at least it's done. One and done. What about you guys?
To add on to that, LPS took, how long did LPS take, Swagger?
Almost 4 hours.
4 hours?
No. Almost
Jared,
4 hours.
How long did TDM8 take?
7 hours?
Disappointed, man.
7 hours. Seven.
I'm disappointed.
TDM8 took 7 hours.
God damn it.
I'm disappointed in me too, honestly. But the episodes are longer and there's more content, so I think it'll be more fun to watch.
Boy.
The only time we'd have to do a separate day recording was Told You on Minecraft Season 6. We had to record Battle Sheep on another day, which was the finale. Oh, yeah.
I won that 2 times, but then the actual recorded version? No! I lose!
No, you won because I installed the wrong plugin, you asshole.
Shut up. Nope, that never happened.
Oh, snap.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Anyway, I see a little
thing
in chat quickly. I just want to bring this up just in case the thing drags on. So, there's been a lot of talk about SOM3, and by a lot of talk, I mean people have messaged me and asked me when it's coming out. I can confirm SOM3 will be released after TDM8 is up, so look out for that.
Wait, all of TDM8's up?
Yeah, so yeah, like an end May, June thing.
Okay.
Luigi, before you started talking, I felt like you just like took a big swig of something and went, dude, right, so
Show millionaires, season 3.
Guys,
mm-hmm.
I'm gonna pop a question a bit earlier because the person who suggested it has got to go, but it is actually quite a good question, so I want to put it there. What is the best part of hosting a game show?
Okay.
The end of
I can go first.
He has 2 questions actually.
We'll go with the first one first, and then
who wants it first?
Go Striker.
Okay. I think the best part of it is, and this is sometimes the worst part, but it's also the best part whenever it works, is when you have an idea and you think it's going to work, and then you play it out on the show, and it just works perfectly, like exactly how you envisioned it.
Yeah,
that is exactly the best feeling in the world. The next best feeling is watching everybody, all the comments and stuff, when they see the stuff and all the positive feedback. That's the best. That's the next. But having an idea and watching it come to life and work perfectly is great. The flip side of that is sometimes it turns into a freaking disaster, and you're like, how am I going to salvage this? This is trash.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And you got to figure out something, but anyway.
I can relate to that. I think, Jarrett, when we think of things that we hope went well and then exceeded our expectations, you think of a certain challenge from TDM8. Holy shit. That's a great feeling. And then I think the reactions from the comments are I agree with Striker, like the reactions of the comments, people watching it, people getting excited for it, really really gives me a nice, like, there is reason to do this, like it isn't just a game, but in a way it's more than a game.
You're like a dad and you're seeing it being
definitely.
Yeah, I'm watching my son grow up.
It's great when things go well, but when they go wrong, they tend to go wrong.
That's true. It's not wrong.
Who else? Chalky, Luigi, what do you guys think the best part of this game is?
See, for me, like, it's kind of different, but it's like the same points. Like, seeing all the reactions, just the things that, like, happen in SOM, when people are kind of just like, what? And then just getting those reactions to the stuff I build is funny. and all the comments and stuff also laughing along at the people's misery.
Retweet.
That's fun to see.
I think if I had to say anything myself from hosting this one season, is that what Dan said is exceeding our expectations. That's what makes it really fun. Since you expect something from the contestants, but whenever they do something different and it blows your mind, it's like, whoa, this is a lot cooler than I thought it was. Like, game plan. Whatever.
At me.
Hey.
Hey. Okay. Thanks for following, David.
Okay. Chuck, you get some of that onto that, or?
Well, with Tribal Wars, the thing is, I try to make it as difficult as I can. So for me, it's seeing them finally do that one little bit, that, like the Tribal Wars Ancients finale.
Just on a side note, for the people who participated in it, if it wasn't for me, it would be a lot harder. Like, no joke, I was like, Joe,
it was an LPS horse race situation.
I had to step in and be like, Striker.
But the thing is, Sander didn't do quite as good of a job of making me make it easier. It's just seeing them finally finish it, and you're like, yes, I'm proud of you.
I want to throw a quick note on this. We were at almost at an hour from recording, and we've got a lot more questions. We should probably try to pick up the pace just a little bit so we don't have this thing run too long.
Okay. He's gonna notice that too.
Okay. Alright, what's Andy's second part of the question? What's your favorite part of being a contestant in TDM, the Strikeout?
Winning.
I can't really.
Yeah, this answer is similar to my other one. Whenever I'm playing in TDM, my favorite part of playing in TDM is watching my ideas come to life. And
yo, so tweet added.
My favorite part,
fire.
Finding out.
It's lit.
Fire.
Peel.
Dude, can I get some fucking water, please? I need an extinguisher.
The kazoo.
The kazoo.
I saw that question three pages down. I'm like, I got the perfect response.
Next question. Do you like your fans? Nope.
Or not.
Okay, guys. Let's have Chalky say his part because he's been trying
to say
it. Let's
go back to the contestant thing.
I've been trying to say it for forever.
Okay, go ahead, Chalky.
My favorite part of TDM is when in TDM 7 I found out that like 5 of my friends have betrayed me. At
oh
Jarrett.
My god!
It's how the game works.
We're moving on to the next question. Go, somebody delete that. It's gone.
I'm not actually
Ben the Gaming God asks, what is your favorite Undertale character?
Never played it.
Never played it.
Sonic.
I love am I the only one that's played this?
Let me ask Brian real quick. Brian, what's your favorite Undertale character? Sand,
yeah.
Dude, shout out to Brian. He's here.
Literally.
This is in the back. Sands.
Sands is honestly one of the coolest characters. So he's really well-rounded and developed. Like, the rest of the characters aren't
like
really that
good.
I totally
like
agree
with
you based on my experience.
Yes.
Like Sonic. So. Press 1 in chat for Sonic. Just in general.
Should we do this next one? Because I feel like we kind of already answered it. Or let's just do the last part of it if you want to.
Yeah. That can go for all our game shows. Like, not just Strike Out.
Or, no, let's just say, what is your favorite moment from all of ours? Just one.
Yeah.
There you go. Okay. All right, you can read it.
Take it.
Luigi?
No, I don't want to read it.
Oh, do something.
I'll answer the question. That's
all right, I'll read it.
What is your favorite moment from a game show you've played or been in or produced? Game shows.
Just going to let you guys answer. I'll go next.
That one thing in TDM8.
Yeah, I feel like that's mine too. And nobody
knows
yet. My favorite moment is the one you can't talk about yet.
Yeah.
Episode 6 of Total Drama Minecraft Season 8. Episode 6 is my favorite thing I've ever done.
Can somebody type it in chat because I've forgotten?
You'll see, it's lit.
Oh, we can't say it. We're gonna spoil things.
Can somebody type it in chat?
I'll send it to you.
I'm gonna message you.
Wait, I got the message. Oh yeah, that was the best thing ever. That was beautiful.
Get ready for episode 6 of TDM 8, folks. Yeah.
I think if I want to pick a favorite moment, I might go with the finale from season 8 from Strikeout.
That was pretty hype. I watched that.
That was fun. That was cool.
Yeah, that was also
the season 6 finale for Strikeout.
That was intense.
My favorite one was Connect
4.
Connect 4 is intense.
Anyways.
Like, it is.
Favorite strikeout game?
Favorite strikeout game, Bomberman. That was really fun.
I like Bomberman was fun. Or platformer.
Bomberman.
Shut up with your platformer.
I might have to go with platformer. I don't know.
Shut up with your stupid platformer.
Platformer, it's raining anvils, rescue crew, or...
Shut up with rescue crew. That was
Super Sumo, because I just camped and I won.
Yeah, Super Sumo is better for... Not strikeout. Moving on. It's just like a game you could just like respawn in, that'd be great. What's the next question?
You do know Chalky made it to episode 6. That is a spoiler. Whoops.
Oh.
No. Next question.
Jared, are you ever gonna do a face reveal? No. It's not my face. Anyways, moving on.
Jared is a pineapple.
Question for Dan. Who do you think is the best performing competitor who hasn't won a TDM?
Gamershano 5.
Retweet.
Not 8?
Been in one episode only, and she's amazing.
Oh shit, I forgot it.
Next question.
We got a question in chat I think is pretty interesting. This guy's like the game show. It's like, it just says Dan, Strike, Luigi, but Jer and Sandy can answer this too.
Okay.
What were your favorite challenges from your game show? Like the ones you
I think we kind of just did that.
Todd,
I like Todd.
Like,
I did mine.
A-Rock 111.
I'll list mine. Hold on, Dan.
Dan, we went through Strikeout and TDM, but not through the other two.
Yeah, I haven't gone through SOM, the OG game show. I can't tell you what hasn't gone up yet, but as of now, my favorite challenge is Statue Challenge in SOM.
You're so dumb, Dan.
Chalky Sander?
I like Pod. It was the one challenge I made completely on my own, and people enjoyed it. It was fun.
My favorite from Tribal Wars Ancients is the updated version of Cobble Climbers, as seen in EDM4.
I like that one.
Pretty lit.
Screw the enemy team, by the way, for focusing me on that one.
Next question, Dan.
A-Rock 111 asks, this is going to be asked more than once, I guess not, but how did you guys get into YouTube gaming?
Quick answer, Yogscast.
Lingmaster 13.
5 years ago.
Quick answer, I like gaming and YouTube, so why not have both?
Boom.
Steel.
This one's a good one. Get your curses out of the way.
Oh crap! I read this one earlier.
Ben the Gaming God asks, if you had to date anyone that has been in your game show, who would it be? Jarrett.
What?
No, I wasn't asking you. I was just telling you that.
No, I looked over at the opposite screen, and then I'm like, wait, what did you submit A for? And I read the question. I'm like, oh,
Jarrett.
Oh, okay.
We're together. Anyone else want to...
Sorry, Hannah.
Anyone else?
I'm gonna have to go with myself here. Because I competed in a game show and hosted one, so yeah, I'm gonna go with
this. Alright, so the ships so far are Luigi and himself, Dan, Jarrett, go on.
Luigi G.
Striker, Tomb, Chalky.
Striker and like, Sniper.
I don't know.
I feel very scared answering this question, especially since there has been joking about it, because finding people in this group that are over 18 is sometimes very difficult.
Oh, I didn't even think about 18. That. Holy crap.
Hold on. Oh,
God.
Holy God.
I know. I'm 23.
I'm 21.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
I'm 19. That isn't too bad, but it's sometimes like people are like, every now and then it's like, I have to be really careful because some people, especially the people on Mumble, whenever there's like something, I have to be really careful because they'll call me like a pedo for jokes, but because everybody I date is would be dating is underaged and there is no overaged girls.
I like dating people that are in like physically like with me.
Yeah,
I like to date midgets too.
Hey, you you lay off my seven dwarves, all right? They're nice.
I know. Thank you.
Anyways.
Right, answer the question. No, answer the question.
I'm pleading the fifth.
Great question.
I'm doing the same as Striker.
Wait, we can't answer this question.
Wait, Chalky. What about you?
What?
Lewis, right?
Who would you date?
Oh, good point, though.
From the game show.
That was the most innocent one. What?
I mean, I'm taken, so no.
Who's your man, Candy Monday, talking? We know.
DJ Shadow Wolf 420 asks, how many fan contestants have won a game show on their first appearance? None.
Yet.
Yeah.
None yet.
Winky face.
Maybe, I don't know.
Kappa.
DJ Shadow Wolf 420 also asked, who would win a triple threat PvP battle between Dan Stryker and Jarrett? Stryker.
Well, I'm injured, remember?
Exactly.
As of right now, Jarrett would win.
Yeah, as of right now, Jarrett would win.
When I go back to Hilltop and train my hone my skills again.
We'll be one in Bad Lion. Well, we'll make a stream all about it.
I killed you in Bad Lion.
That was so stupid. I wish I still had it.
The competition is out of the league. Dylan 10,000
asks, if you had to be stranded with one person from Strikeout in general, who would you pick, like on a desert island?
And this could be just any of our group.
I think Strikeout, because he looks like he knows what he's doing.
He's got a suit on. He's got to know what he's doing.
He'd provide for the family. By family, I mean just me and Strikeout. He'd provide for us both.
Do I have a say in this?
We're on an island, Striker. You gotta survive, man. You gotta do what it takes while I just kinda watch.
Alright.
I'm gonna go for Samsor because it looks like he's a cyborg guy and he could fly down the island.
Retweet. Hey, that's cheating.
I think I'm gonna take Luigi, actually, because
yeah.
I think that if I had to kill him for food, I could.
How do you know
but
that
the thing
I
is that
food.
You won't get much meat from it.
If push came to shove,
oh wow, Jarrett. Okay, that minute that I heard that.
Just
I don't think it'd be much of a fight. All right, I'm gonna go for.
You'll be asleep. You'll
I'm gonna go for Flores.
You won't see it coming.
Oh, that's
asleep.
Cute. That's
gonna
nice.
Go Flores?
I'm gonna go with Flores. Great teamwork, as shown before. Mm-hmm. And secondly, he may be about like just slightly shorter than me and probably stronger than me, but I can kill him without an issue.
Oh,
this is probably. Really creepy. I would
seems to be a natural thing to say.
I would go with Ace Rider, mainly because
like
we'll probably get into a fight a couple days in, and then we'll see who survives.
Oh.
It'll be
fun. Because we're sisters.
All right. What's your favorite season?
Or Chalky for head.
Sorry.
Favorite season.
Just favorite show of your favorite season of your respective shows.
Of like the ones that we've hosted.
Yes.
yeah,
my favorite season of Last Player Standing is season one.
No, I don't know. I wouldn't
say.
I think in general, and I've always said this, I think that in general, every season has been better than the one before it. So season 8 is currently the best. I think season 9 will probably be the new best whenever it comes out.
Because hopefully
Strikeout, I like season 8. TDM, I like season 8. Show of Millionaires, I like season 1 because that's the only one I've been in, even though I tried to be in the other ones and timing didn't work. And Tribal Wars season 2 because I worked on that a lot more.
That question was by the Zombie Slayer 78.
Yeah, and then SOM3 Winky Face is my favorite.
The original Tribal Wars, which has 3 episodes, is the best one.
Yeah,
is that
Akka,
up?
I think all the seasons are good. If they weren't, I think I'd probably take them down. But
oh,
but I still think the other ones are better after Anyway.
Yeah. They get better over time, yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
You learn from mistakes.
Exactly.
That's like my Club Penguin videos. They get better if you ignore the cringe.
They get better with time. It's like a fine wine. All right. Yeah. For the Q&A, are you a unicorn?
Yes.
Jad's Toad?
I'm going to
have a horn. But
maybe.
Oh.
I'm going to play the fifth on this one. I can't really disclose that.
I don't even know what the question was.
The lovely answers among the people.
Alex Garza asks, how many times do you think it will take Ace to lose?
17 times.
Or maybe at least another eight.
Wink. I don't
Never.
Know.
Never. Winky face.
Who knows? Honestly, who knows? Really, who knows? He can win Topaz, but he slacks in other places. I don't know.
We've kind of already answered the next one. So, have we? Or
here's a...
Yeah, we did.
Yeah. Alright, this one's a pretty good one.
Yeah, this can go to all of our game shows, I guess, because it kind of... Mainly TDM, but like, we can all answer
What
it.
Do you think about, insert game show, audience, obsession with female contestants? Well, yeah, TDM
Whoever
is probably
wants to answer
more
first,
likely.
I'll
yeah, we
I'll
can...
Answer.
I'll do I think Dan should answer.
Just let Dan answer on his own.
Fuck you. All right. So, you okay, dude?
die carefully.
Guys, the flood's getting to him. Oh, bye.
He's drowning.
Bye. Oh, all right, Dan, answer us. No
Help
pass.
Me!
No.
Come back.
No pressure.
I think that this is not meant to generalize, but when there is a lack of one gender, when that gender that is lacking is introduced, it's something different from the other contestants, and you just, I don't know, the audience is mainly... boys, I assume. So, I would
horny
think that
horny little boys.
Horny little boys, and they like girls, and I don't blame them. Girls are awesome. So, I mean, I don't really have a problem with it.
Somebody here contradicts.
It is what it is, you know.
Yes, Chalky, we know you disagree with this.
I've never covered.
But you're currently taken. So,
I'll throw my two cents in on this. So, personally, I think we kind of all, at some point or another, kind of, I don't really care. If you're a boy or a girl, if you're going to join the show, we don't like pick or choose a certain way. But you got to look at who we're working with. We're working with people who are, one, hanging out on the internet. So majority of that is going to be swayed one way already, right? Then you go Minecraft. It sways a little bit more that way. And then you go to a certain age, which about teenage years, it sways a little bit more that way. So you get the 1% of the 1% of the 1% of girls that are still interested in playing. And then finding them, right, and then having them even have a slight interest in hanging out with any of us, which is a miracle, right, then getting them to show up for the recording, just like any other person, the 1% of the 1% or whatever, right, so it's impossible to bring them in, but I think the obsession is kind of exactly what Dan said. It's just, I don't think at the end of the day we really care too much about who plays. It's more about giving everybody their shot. I don't know.
For us, the girls are there. For the viewers, it's like, girls.
Chromosomes.
I was going to say wet panties, but, you know, it's usually guys.
Oh, okay.
All right, next up.
Yeah, once we're done with this, I got like six PMs on Discord that I'll run through after we're done with these questions. I think I've probably, I assume they're questions.
Yeah.
Is that it? Oh, we got more here. We want to answer that one right there.
Point this out. Just this one in the comments.
Community cues.
Did Luigi make the logo for the live stream? Yes. Moving on.
Of course.
Okay.
Did Luigi make any logo? Yes.
Yeah.
Are we going to do that throwback question or not?
No.
Wait.
Okay. It's to me. It's from Hatsum.
Not important.
Oh.
Dan, you want to answer that one right here? One tailor.
Peacock plays.
Yeah.
Peacock Plays asks if I got his shipment, or if I forgot about my shipment of hams and yams, of spam hams and yams. No, I received it. Everything was fine. Jarrett just changed the font to Comic Sans.
No, I didn't. that wasn't me.
What's this?
Let's just skip that one.
yeah, we'll skip that one.
Skips.
All right, next question.
AJ McCracken asks, who is Bay?
Who is Bay, Chalky?
Hey, Bay McCracken.
Oh,
Bunny
snap.
Asks, "What at it's that one?" Bunny asks, "What's your favorite color of the alphabet?"
Green.
9.
Hey.
4. Yes.
Purple.
Green.
Dynamic.
Jared, are you gonna play? Yeah. After this.
What is the longest video that you've recorded and realized that you never clicked the record button?
Didn't you record or miss an episode or two of DDM a while back then?
TDM3, I didn't record episode 2, I think. The TNT split, I did not record.
Oh, yeah,
I didn't record.
I'll throw this out here. I recorded all of season 6 without any audio. Kind of counts, right? Oh, I had to redouble.
Did anyone notice? Nope.
Yeah.
Hey.
Never had anything like that.
Not gonna lie, like, I remember what, like, I watched over season 6, like, a while ago. And I forgot that you recorded over. And I was like, oh, yeah.
Nice.
All right, another one?
I had one time where I had clicked preview stream rather than click the record button.
Oh.
So I thought I was recording. Luckily, like, at one point, I realized it. And it's like, fuck, guys. But yeah, it wasn't too much.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
From Nick.
Nick the Trickster 45 asks, who would win the foot race? Jarrett, Luigi, Dan, Chalky, or the door?
Sander, the you door. And me just didn't make it out the door.
Yeah, no. Striker, we are already at the end. Like,
yeah, we already won. Yeah,
we took the horses. We weren't stupid. We just sat on the horses and walked it.
For us, like, idiots, I don't
know. Why would you walk this out in front?
Door. Yeah, if we have a meetup, we need to have a foot race to see.
Dude, I'm Speedy Gonzalez. Let's go. Let's go.
Hey, don't try me. You'll get speeded out.
GG 10.
Alright, next question. Are these all from Dead Yet?
Yep.
These are all from Dead Yet. This can't be good.
Oh.
No.
Okay. What do you really love to do?
No.
Do you do it often?
Yeah.
If you answer no, why not?
Yes.
Oh.
Okay. We love playing games. Do you do it often? Yes. There. Question done. When you think about your game shows, what immediately comes to mind and why? Annoying contestants.
Cancer.
Next.
Mm. Oh.
What makes you smile and why?
Hannah.
When you think of your game shows, what immediately comes to mind? Lots and lots of manual labor.
Pain.
Yes.
Retweet. Actually retweet.
By manual labor, I mean moving my mouse and clicking.
Yeah. Having to do redstone for a whole game show that took 6 months to build in 1 week.
It took 6 months to build because 1.9 didn't come out.
And then
out.
Have the server.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, you could not had 6 months, right?
Yeah, but I wasn't part of the building crew. I was part of the redstone crew, which gave me a week for. Actually, I built a challenge, and it took me 1 day to build the challenge.
Anyone else want to answer Dead Yet's questions? Like, should we move along?
That was all.
Dead Yet, you make me smile.
Yes.
Retweet.
Alright.
Break, yeah.
This is a good one. You mean to do this one?
Yep.
Alright, I don't think we have a person that sent this one. Oh, well. When did you guys meet? And follow-up question, what is your favorite movie? How about quick, everyone answer movie, and then we'll...
Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Best movie, hands down. Or Saving Private Ryan.
Club Penguin the movie by Luigi Spanish.
Back to the Future's my favorite movie.
I'm going to go with Lone Survivor.
That's
I haven't seen that yet.
You haven't seen that?
No.
That was fantastic.
Wow. All right, great. Well, I'll have to see it then.
Yeah. Mark Wahlberg.
That's the guy in Transformers.
My favorite film is The Room.
Same.
If you've not heard of it, you should really check it out.
You're tearing me apart, Lisa.
I did not.
So the when
don't
did you guys make them?
Don't tear me apart, Lisa.
This
I
is
don't
YouTuber
have a
show.
Favorite movie, by the way.
This is a striker that we met.
Because of something called Server Cubic, which was an SMP back in the day that I now have ownership of, but I don't do anything with it. And then I met Striker, weirdly on a server called 1337 or Elite Builders.
We didn't meet there.
We met there.
No, we just didn't know.
We met, but we didn't actually like talk until I joined the community. I mean, not the community, YouTuber's chat.
Yeah, I was gonna tell that kind of quick story. It was just created this whole YouTuber chat a long time ago that brought all these people together. We had up to like 60 members at one point. A lot of the guys you see around are from that. Not everybody though. Some of them we met afterwards. And Dan was one of the early members.
And admins.
Jarrett was not far after him.
That's how I met Jarrett too.
Hey.
Yeah.
And I was kind of pushed in here as the fan contestant.
And then Sander I met through SMP.
Oh, yeah. And then, wait, I met you. I was already thinking earlier today when I read that question. It was like, how the hell did I get introduced to all these game shows? But it was the concept, me, and then I got into the YouTubers chat, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It was basically, I was good friends with Sander, and we were like, dude, you want to compete in this game show with me? It was my first time competing, or whatever. And I was like, Sander, come and do it with me. And he got out first.
I did get out first.
Oh, well, it was close.
I got second place that time. TDM3, first game show.
I was talking about Strikeout or something.
Strikeout. Yeah, Strikeout, I went out first.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like, you pulled the lever on me.
I know, dude.
You pulled the lever on me, you bastard.
That's true friendship right there.
Alright, next one. Who would win a 6-man PvP battle royale podcast group?
At the moment, probably Luigi, but I think it'd be a
excuse me! I would like to differ!
Don't try.
This
me.
Guy's got bad lion skills!
I would have killed him that day. I would have won that day.
But like, I will still try.
But once Striker gets his mojo back, it's him.
Yeah, really.
Jerry, you're garbage.
I know I'm bad.
Hey,
we're gonna have a
read over the question. I don't know if we should even bother for that.
No.
That just seems controversial.
It's not like I care. That's not bad. It's just like,
it's just,
if you guys are
accurate, someone's gonna get pissed off.
Probably.
What's the question?
Alright. How do you pick people for the game shows? I think we all kind of do it differently.
For
me, I just like, just friends.
Friends. You invite people that you'd like.
Dan, you wanna go over your way?
In terms of the fan
contestants, but in terms of fan contestants, you just gotta make me laugh and you gotta have a nice personality.
Good voice.
You want to be friends with from then on out.
Yeah. I gotta like see you as my friend. Like I saw Luigi as my friend. I'm like, this guy is pretty cool. We have stuff in common.
Yeah, we have goals, but not really.
Why is Jarrett here?
Excuse me. Excuse me.
Alright,
this would explain why he's not participating anymore.
Excuse me.
Oh.
There you go.
Give him the business.
Next podcast, we're gonna have to get a very big bucket of water.
Jarrett's name will be crossed out.
Alright, whatever.
Are we done with all these?
On twitch.tv/danhamdan.
Oh my gosh.
I've got a whole series of PM questions I should probably get to.
Hey, guys.
Oh god.
What about the last question?
Yeah. When will Dan have sex with me?
Asked by Katy Perry on Twitter. Yes.
is this from actual Katy Perry? I'm presuming
it's not Katy Perry. She asked me.
Well, she didn't put community cues, so it may be a different Dan.
Katie, I'm right across the street. You're my neighbor, Katy Perry. Call me up on my phone. Alright, so now it's time to take questions from our Discord.
Yeah, let me throw. I got a bunch of me. Just burn through mine, burn through somebody else's. We'll go through, have them all answer.
Okay.
Alright. I got, will you have fan contestants for Strikeout Season 9? Probably. Where is talent show, Jarrett?
One
retweet.
1K.
Tell it, Joe.
So is that your answer, guys?
Yeah, at 1K. So I already have it all planned out. It's just I'm not gonna start until I get to 1K or close to it.
Subbot, Jarrett, please.
Question: if you were to do season 10, would you make it an all fan cast? No, I'm working on something that. And let me think about it. But I'm probably going to announce something at the end of the stream. To me.
Yay.
Oh, snap.
I think that's about it. How did all of you meet up? We already went over that, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Can you do my question right now? I gotta go. An hour ago.
I'm presuming.
Come on, man.
Just you and me. Question: how all of you able to join the game show? How all of you able to join the Strikeout game show? I think kind of with everybody else, kind of what we said is, you know, if you're part of the community, that's how you get in. You talk to the members. You talk to us. Whenever we do these kind of events.
Just be a nice guy.
Be a nice guy, yeah.
Us with messages.
And if you get lucky, you'll get in. It's kind of, there's a lot of people that want to play, and not everyone can. So,
yeah.
Video promoting.
Last one for me. How much longer do you think the community will live on for? As long as people stay in it, and as long as we have an interest, and we don't kill Luigi, then I think it'll all be good.
Yeah.
I think we'll keep it running for a while.
Darren, kill me, please.
Okay, Nick, just give me another one. So, is Strikeout Fan Edition still happening? More on that later.
Pencil King asks, Jarrett face reveal question mark?
We were actually talking about that, weren't we, earlier? Yeah. I was like, we could do this with face cam. And Jarrett was like, no. And we didn't. And because Jarrett was late, we couldn't set it up so that he would have a meme face. So maybe next time podcast without Jarrett's face.
All right.
I got an interesting question from Alex Gaza. If you had to choose, who would you save from falling off a high cliff, Dan or Striker?
Striker. Sorry.
I'd make a sandwich. No, joking.
I'd
save Striker.
I've only played in one strikeout, and I've played in a lot of TDM. And strikeout challenges are stupid, the ones I got out in. So I gotta let go of your strikes. Nothing personal. It's just the way the world spins.
Well, then the striker can't improve if you don't say.
Yeah, but it doesn't have to when you're
Andy
falling.
Andy Duthie asks me, will I ever do iCarly Wii again? The answer is, I sure hope not. Mario Fan 1. Okay, he was just asking me about strikers PM.
Oh, wait. I got a question about him, actually.
IG Afterglow, this is for everyone. What is the best video you've made?
My TDMA announcement.
By far. Mine is, Who's Your Daddy?
I was about to say that! Let's go!
Let's
go! Can I make a quick announcement?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Who's Your Daddy? Part 2. Father's Day.
Let's go!
Prepare for Father's Day!
Press the one in the chat right now.
Guys, this is just something I want to put out there, right?
Yeah, go for it.
People calling, like calling me daddy, like their daddy or something. No, a lot of you are fine with this, but it semi creeps me out. However, there was one exception. At one point during Tribe Wars, a specific member, I will not be saying the name, didn't say daddy, but called me papa. And I was like, this is acceptable because daddy can be interpreted wrong and papa is like, you know, this is actually kind of funny. I like this.
Could I add on to that?
Daddy. Yeah.
If you guys go to my Twitter right now, at DanTaTheKelly, I retweeted a poll that asks you what you call Dan Kelly. The options are Daddy, Dad, Father, and Dan. Please go bombard that Twitter poll.
I'm going to pull that up. I have Twitter open right now. I'm getting that.
Retweet.
Yeah, at DanTaTheKelly is my Twitter. I retweeted it a few. You're going to have to scroll down a little bit, but please go answer that poll. It's very important to me.
I'm about to paste it.
Infernox asked me, how was my birthday? It was nice.
Yeah.
Retweet.
There was a favorite video question earlier, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. If you search on my channel for Machinima, I did like 10 of them a long time ago with James. Some of those things are so cringeworthy, but they're freaking hilarious.
When is Things You Only Hear in Minecraft coming back?
Man, I really did enjoy that. It's just,
wait, what?
I know, I actually, like, honestly thought it was funny.
Yeah,
it's cool.
It's fun.
What was the question? I was distracted for a second.
Things you can only say in Minecraft?
That was one of the series.
Hashtag white supremacy.
Whoa, I don't like that one bit.
Oh, you were you there for that, Dan? No, you weren't, were you?
He was on the white team in TDM in Strikeout 8.
Oh, yeah. Well.
And we were kind of owning throughout Strikeout.
Yeah, there's on the next episode thing that I did for, I think it was episode 2, and Forrest just goes,
no, it's episode 1. It's episode 1. It's like, one person's like, oh my god, and suddenly Flores is always, white power! End of the episode. Video cuts.
This is good.
Yep, we've got Billy Bo shouting out hashtag white supremacy. Yeah,
that could have been us.
Kids don't do this outside, especially not in bad neighborhoods. Go on!
Why bad neighborhoods?
I don't know, good neighborhoods, you get arrested.
What makes them bad?
Ned Flanders is my favorite.
Bad neighborhoods, you get stabbed.
Bad neighborhood.
What else you got?
Anyone else
say
that?
I'll probably message.
I've got another one from Infernox. What are your guys' favorite hobbies besides Minecraft and video games? What about you guys?
Is there something outside of video games?
Theater.
No, joking. I play
job. I guess is my favorite
comedy
thing.
Wait, don't you do karate, Striker?
Singing.
It's not karate.
I'm part of a role-playing club here.
Nerd.
Riley. Yay, I'm a nerd. Screw you guys.
I enjoy
my role-playing. I'm actually participating in a LARP not next weekend, but the weekend after. Filming.
Education is fun. I enjoy learning.
I enjoy teaching.
I can agree with you.
You and I can be friends.
Oh boy, teach me, please.
Papa.
I'll teach you something.
Uh-oh.
All right, next question.
Yeah.
I don't even know anymore.
Right. What have we got next? Anyone?
Are we out of questions? Did we actually get through all these?
We gotta have more.
From Billy Burt says, do you know anyone who sexually identifies as a lawnmower? What do you guys think?
You say as a lawnmower?
A lawnmower?
Yeah.
You know me, don't ya? I'm kidding. That's weird. I don't like
to chop you up like a lawnmower.
I can answer this question in the worst possible way, and because of that, and because this is currently live on Twitch and Striker is recording this, I will not do this.
I appreciate it.
I can. No, I'm not going to just say this. Go on.
Brom, winky face. Kappa.
If y'all can keep going for a little bit, I'm trying to get something done so I can post it as soon as we're done.
Same.
I'm just kind of looking through all the questions.
Oh, Bunny asks, hashtag community questions. Yas?
No. Free winky face. Yas.
Oh, wait, we've got a question in the Twitch chat. One in the Twitch chat. Out of all the new fan casts, not including me and Phoebe, who two would you choose to be stranded on an island with Infernox? Presto, Claude, Billy, or Nick? So you're choosing someone to be stranded with Infernox.
No,
I choose Infernox.
It's not who's be stranded with Infernox, it's
which two with Infernox?
Probably Nick. I'm not gonna lie.
I'm gonna say Infernox and
Presto
and Billy and Nick and Claude.
Actually, yeah, Presto and Infernox. Prestoxo, let's go.
I'm gonna be honest. I don't know anybody but Infernox well enough to answer this question. I'm a terrible person.
Again, yep. We've got just a quick one. How did Rabe and Maria get on Chumma? They're my friends, and Nick was cool.
Oh, yeah.
That's it. I'm just kind of looking through the Twitch chat, seeing if we got anything else.
Anybody got questions?
Anybody,
dump them right now.
Last question.
How do I ask questions, Mr. Happy Games? Well, just
retweet.
Type them out with hashtag community queue.
That is my question. How do you
Or you literally say, I have a question, and then put your question.
It's easier to
or
see
just
with
put
the
a question.
Hashtag for me.
Yeah, it's easier to see with the hashtag. Okay, for Striker and Luigi, you guys ever have a day where you go on Discord for a few hours and talk to fans, kind of like an interview for fan contestants for your game shows?
happens. See, I'll let you go first, Striker.
The thing is, for the interview, if people knew they were being interviewed, they would not act the way they would.
Yeah,
exactly. So
that's exactly right.
I'm kind of always listening and paying attention. If someone seems like they're a mature
person, I do it as well. Is like, I'm kind of just like, hey guys, we're gonna like play on like just a Mindplex server. And I like kind of judge how they're acting around others too. Like Nick at the time was kind of like, all right guys, quiet down, talk at once. And like he was being all nice and stuff. And I'm like, all right, he'll make a pretty cool contestant. And same with like someone else that I haven't named yet, but Winky Face for SOM3.
All right.
On the note of the being on the Discord, it's like every time I want to be on Discord, it's like I've got a couple hours I can be in Discord, right? But nobody comes on Discord in the time slot that I want to be on Discord. It's like empty. It's barren. Barren wasteland. And then I'm talking to people on Mumble, and then in the evening when I have to go to bed or something, it's like Discord is full with people. It's like...
Yeah, I do say that. I mean, I work during the time when people are getting out of school, and I usually get home by the time y'all are going to sleep. So I'm not on the peak hours for this server, I assume. And I've been kind of inactive with my finger. I haven't really been on the computer much, but I'll be more active in the coming days and weeks and stuff.
Yeah.
Are we wrapping up, are we gonna keep going?
I've got a few more. I have two that are at me.
I want to say this real quick. Are you guys wanting to play Minecraft for a little bit with everybody, or
up to you guys? Like, I'm not really feeling it, but if we have to,
I don't know yet. But I can stay for.
I kind of feel like just asking the lot, answering the last few. I've got a few that are at me. I don't know about you.
We'll play Minecraft here in like 10 minutes. So let's just
answer these last few.
I have to go after the questions though, because my brother's birthday tomorrow. Everybody go to Broken Pixel's channel and say happy birthday to him.
Can I throw out my two big
announcements? I need to go to bed on time, so.
Yeah, sure. Yep.
Alright, first big announcement. The sing-along competition results have just been posted. It's live right now.
Yo, I just got 800 subscribers. Oh. Yeah.
So that video is out. And you guys made me sing in it. That's something to look at.
You're at 798.
Shut up.
Then the last thing is Strikeout Fan Edition. I'm going to record it next Saturday. I haven't figured out a time yet. I'm going to put up more details during the week.
Guys, that's next week.
I'm going to record it this coming Saturday, which is like 6 days from now. So more details during the week. But
just it's happening. Yeah. On a side note, OnlyFans, right?
For the congratulations.
It's OnlyFans. So.
Okay, good to know.
Yep. It's not Strike Out Fan Edition, so that you can come play.
Yeah. No, but.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, it'll be Fan Edition.
Because I couldn't do next Saturday. So.
Yeah, it'll be cool. Yeah, all right. More announcements probably this week. I would assume by Wednesday time and decide about how it's going to work.
So. I have a special announcement.
Watch on Discord. Alright.
Okay, so there's been a lot of talk asking, so this question as well, just revolving around the topic.
Hey.
Luigi Spanish. So this one was for Luigi. Where's Total Drama Club Penguin? Now, I've been talking about bringing back Total Drama Club Penguin. I teased it in the little Christmas stream we did last year. I can confirm... No release.
Oh my god!
But working on it. I'm writing the script this week and then getting all the voice actors. Filming starts next week. You can expect it in like soon.
Oh my god. I hate my life.
That's my big announcement.
Hey.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is there anything else you want to follow? Before we wrap it?
Anyone else want to... Thanks for subscribing. Give me the 800. Let's go! Hi!
Are we up to any amount of Discord users? To be grow
I don't know. Can you check?
I would
assume
not.
Yeah,
I think we grew by one!
Yeah! I've reached 300 Twitch followers too, so thank you for that too. I appreciate it.
You got 300 Twitch followers?
Yes.
We could also, Jared... You weren't here because you were, you know, like, late. But we were talking before you showed up about possibly doing something like this on a somewhat regular basis.
Yeah.
Not necessarily like every weekend, but maybe like every other week, every month, like every doing like a Q&A or a
maybe a month, just
a stream and hang out with the fans, in a formal fashion. So
yeah,
that might be happening.
Let me put something in the chat and say, community
fan along competition results.
Stream.
I will watch that later.
I got a question about the fan edition thing. I'm going to put out a lot more details coming on this week, but they're two separate shows. It's not like fan edition is not season 9. It's fan edition is going to be its own thing.
Everybody go and vote in this. I want to see what you guys say. I'll be up for doing more community streams because I thought this was pretty fun.
Where is this? Oh, okay. I see.
The straw polling.
I agree. I'm going to go for general. Every month.
I am too.
Probably.
I think month.
We don't want it to get too old. Remember that, guys, when you're voting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, wow. Do you play? Oh, it's split right now.
It already has 12 votes.
Dang, dude.
And it's
put
50-50.
It in Discord, too. Yeah, oh. Put it in Discord.
We just don't want it to be like, oh, how did you come up?
Hold on.
Oh, how did you come up with strikeout? Oh, how did you come up with strike? You know what I mean? It'd just be the same questions over
I think
and over
it'll be every month, yeah. If anything.
And I yeah. think that well, we ourselves can.
What's that about the podcast version of the
maybe,
portion of
maybe.
Screen?
Yeah. Maybe we do like a podcast every month and we do.
And I think we can also make the podcast rather than only fan questions. We could come up with topics to talk about ourselves too.
Yeah, right. I agree with that.
That don't necessarily relate to the game shows themselves because I think we've covered a lot of the game show topics.
Yeah. And there's always new people coming in too. We got to remember
that.
I
agree.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
Some things are going to be duplicated, but.
Well, should we all sign out from this podcast section?
Yeah, are we?
Sounds good.
We're going to switch over to actually playing games. So what we're going to do is we're going to get Luigi Spanish to open up his Mindplex server if he wants to plug that in the chat. And everybody can play with us. And we're just going to be talking
how
about
long,
and
for people
how long
watching on
me
and Striker's channels, this is in the past, so it's not actually going to, you know.
Yep.
Yeah, thanks for watching the podcast, guys.
Yeah, let's do an outro. Since
if you like this, let us know, and we'll do more of it. My name is Dan. Yeah. Everyone else,
Tracker.
My
name is Jarrett.
Yeah.
As I, Doom God, because people find that funny whenever I do that.
Chalky's gay.
Chalky.
I am Luigi Spanish.
Right. Well, that's it. Guys, see
thank you guys for watching. Bye.
Safe tries and bye sales.
Bye. Have a good time.
Okay.